Hello students, in this video we will discuss about the heuristic search strategies in artificial intelligence. This video contains the greedy base for search, A star search, heuristic problem, hill climbing search, simulated annealing process, local beam search and constraint satisfaction problem. The first point is the greedy base for search. So basically in my earlier video we have discussed about what? The uniform cost search, which is a blind search. In this video we are discussing about the informed search, which is not a blind video, which is not a blind search technique. It's a technique where it always searches for a optimum solution. One example is the greedy best first search. It is not a BFS. BFS is a breadth first search. It is a greedy best first search. So in this technique the theory is, in each and every step we will count the profit margin of some situation. Okay, so suppose we are standing on a node A, the total tree is like this. In the step 5 you can see the total tree where all the nodes are visible. As we have started searching from the node A, B, C and D are connected with A, right? So within this part, within the B, C, D, which one is more optimum? The game value is given or the situation value is given. The optimum solution is given by node D. So in the node D we can have the optimum solution of 1, right? So from A we are selecting the next node as node D, not the B and C. After selecting the D, we are expanding D. So when we are expanding D, that time E and F are being expanded, where the game value are 4 and 6 respectively. For selection of the next node, we will compare all the nodes which are now expanded. So we have taken A as a starting node, then we have selected D. After the selection of D, still now B and C is open, and now E and F is furtherly open. So in B, C, E and F, the optimum one is B, as the game value is selected as 3 or the situation value is 3. So when we are selecting B, so we have selected what? We have selected A, then D, then B, right? Now when we are selecting B, the expanded nodes from B is G and H, which is showing 6 and 5 value, and now the open nodes are G, H, C, E, F, where the minimum value is provided by node E. So we can now expand E. Now again we are getting I and J, where J is giving the optimum solution among all the open nodes. So we can select J and we can expand it. So in this way the best first search is working. So if we assume that no further states are connected with these nodes, then after J we will select I, okay, then we will select C or H, anyone, C or H, okay, anyone, either we will select C first then H or we will select H first, then C. After that, we are getting two another nodes, that is G and F. We can take it in any way. We can take G first, F later, or we can take F first and G later. So this is how you can select the nodes in the VD based first search. I hope you have understood this point. The next point is the heuristic function and heuristic search. Before going into the definition, I'm showing you one graph. In this graph, the starting node is S and the goal node is G. So in any way, by any way, we have to reach to the goal state. So we can go by this way, we can go by this way, we can go by this way. So anything, any path we can select based on the cost. Cost we have not mentioned over there. I just want to define which is the heuristic function. So suppose we have started traveled from S node and we are on the I node. The current node is I node, that is the intermediate node, and we have to reach to the goal node. So we have already covered the path from S node to I node, right? So we know what is the cost from S to I. Now heuristic function is a function that estimates the probable cost from the current node to the goal node. It always estimates the cost from the current node to the goal node. Okay? So this is how the heuristic function works. Fine? And the search technique which uses the heuristic function is known as the heuristic search. So the definition of heuristic function is that estimates the cost from the current node to the goal node, and heuristic function is admissible if it always give a minimum cost than the actual cost. For example, suppose from I to G the estimated heuristic cost is suppose 10. But after going through all the path and reaching to the G, we can see that the cost become 11. If we go by this way, then the cost should be like this. If we go by this way, then cost should be like that. So based on the path, the heuristic function estimates the cost. And if we travel the particular path, then the actual cost may differ and it should be greater than the estimated cost. So if it is so, then the heuristic function is known as the admissible heuristic. Fine. So this is what the heuristic function. Now I am coming to the A-star search. It is very simple. It is taking two functions. One is HN. HN is denoted by the heuristic function. And GN. GN is basically the actual cost from the starting node to the current node. So from starting node to current node, the actual cost is denoted by GN, and the estimated cost from the current node to the goal node is being calculated by the HN. So a star search is basically dealing with the FN, which is a summation of GN and HN. So this is the A-star search. Next point is local search and optimization problem. The local search is what? You will have a search space. Obviously, it should not be an infinite. Suppose we are finding some good students. So we are finding the good students among whom? within a class, within a year, within a department, or within a college, or within a university. So such space may differ. Local search gives you a specific area of a search space where you can search your goal. One example of local search is hill climbing method. So what is the problem of hill climbing method? Hill climbing method is you have to climb a hill and reach to the peak of the hill. So basically you have to reach to the highest peak of the hill within a given area. The area should be defined. It should be either like within a city or within a country or within a state, that should be defined. Now, what is the problem of the hill climbing method? So first, I am describing the process of the hill climbing method, that is to find the solution. You are suppose standing on a particular place and you are finding some solution, which one you think better, you just taking that and going to that particular way. So that is a hill climbing method. Okay. So the problem or limitation of the hill climbing method is plain area. If it is a plain area or flat area, it may be in this portion, or it may be a local maximum of a flat area, right? So if you are having a plain area, you are standing and you do not have any eye and you are finding the solution to climb the hill, you are not finding any the place where you can go to the upper section. So that is one limitation. That is a plain surface, right? Local maximum is another limitation of hill climbing method. For example, here two peaks are there, right? From the image we can see that this particular peak is more this is the global maximum, but if you are suppose standing on there somewhere in this particular point, and if you want to climb the hill, so after reaching at this point you will think that you have climbed the hill, you have reached to the highest peak, but actually you have not reached to the so the local maxima is a limitation of the hill climbing method. So this is the problem of the hill climbing method. What is the steepest and ascent hill climbing method? The steepest ascent hill climbing method, the agent, it may be a robot, it may be a human who is climbing the hill, it should analyze the adjacent steps where it is standing, and it is after analyzing the steps, it is getting the best step and taking that particular step and going through that particular position. So this is the steepest ascent hill climbing method. The solution of the problem of hill climbing method is backtracking, obviously, because suppose you have reached in some point and that is not the correct position, then you have to choose the backtrack process. Or if it is possible to make a big jump, that you have already you are in a deadlock and you are not finding any better solution within your region, so in that case you must have to jump from your place to another place so that you can find some another steps. Simulated annealing is a process. It is basically trying to blast a particular local maxima like area, and so that you can get a flat region to go to the global range. For example, suppose the human being is doing blasting on this particular area, and this particular area become like this. Okay, so you will get a clear image from your current point to the global maximum to reach. So this is what the solution of the hill climbing method. Next point is local beam search. Local beam search is the searching technique which is not only focusing on the current level and the next level, it is also focusing on the next to next level. For example, suppose you are standing on the current node and you can have the point, game point, you can say. Either you want to maximize it or you want to minimize it. Suppose your target is to minimize the game value. So you are standing over there, and if you your target is to minimize, then what you will do? You will choose the 5, right? So I am taking one shape to height up to this. So in this two options, you will select, obviously you will select the 5, but you do not know about the next level. What local beam search does, it analyzes the next level also, and in the next level it can see that though 9 is greater than 5, still if it select 9, then in the next level it can get 2 or 3, which is minimum than 6 or 4. So this is the definition of the local beam search. So suppose someone is selecting 9, then the next level, the next one is selecting 3, in the next level it can select 1. So this is how it will work. But the level where you are standing on, okay, you in local beam search, the agent have the ability to analyze the level next to next level. That is, if the agent is standing on the level 1, then it can analyze up to level 3. So that is the local beam search. The last point is constraint satisfaction problem. The constraint satisfaction problem is a problem which is basically following some conditions, and based on the condition it follows the rules of it. For example, DLS, depth limited search, which we have already done in the earlier video, that is basically following the depth first search but with a limitation of the level. Another example is the map coloring problem, endpoint problem. In everywhere we have a condition that in endpoint problem we must search for the safer place, or in the color map coloring problem, the adjacent nodes, two adjacent nodes cannot have the same color. So any problem which obeys some conditions are known as the constraint satisfaction problem. Hope you like my video. If you like my videos, then do subscribe my channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you.